In this episode, I talk about the materials used in the material extrusion process.
For material extrusion, we really have the widest selection of materials available, all thermoplastic, and I'll talk a little bit more about the variety that we have. We have mostly amorphous thermoplastics. They have a glass transition temperature at which the material starts to soften, and the shrinkage during cooling is low, and the viscosity is still relatively high. Viscosity is the resistance to flow. What that means is that the bead that we're extruding keeps its shape really well, and it doesn't shrink too much, and we get gaps between the individual beads. The entanglements or hydrogen bonds, van der Waal bonds between the chains allow the bonding across the weld line from bead to bead and layer to layer. So if we put one bead next to the other, we have those beads to actually weld, and then once we come back and put some on top, we need that to weld as well. Semicrystalline thermoplastics exhibit much higher shrinkage and lower viscosity. Therefore, they're mostly used with reinforcement, which both reduces these effects of shrinkage and the low viscosity. Typical materials that are used are ABS. That's the most common, as well as PLA. But there's variations of ABS. There's ASA and PCABS. Then high-performance materials would be PEI, known as ULTEM, PEEK, PSU, PPSU. Then new materials that are coming in are PETG and polycarbonate. PVA, a soluble support, has been around for a while. Not everybody's using it. A lot of people also use the same material they use for building, just with a sparser setup, and they break it away, so it's a mechanical removement rather than a chemical. And we see more nylons, nylons like polyamide 12, which we also have in powder bed fusion, and that's often used with fibers. And we have the TPEs and TPUs, the thermoplastic elastomers, that give a flexibility. So that's what people want to print with.